barely even feeds his chickens. He has huge compost piles, and the birds run out there. He says they're going to work, and they're so happy, and they have a purpose, you know. They're really happy to get out there and turn that compost, break the pest cycles, eat all the bugs, and he does throw them some grain every once in a while, but he goes, they're so happy, and they're so productive, I'm getting almost too many eggs. And, you know, if you want to have a bunny, bunnies are great composters. They'll eat things that maybe the chickens wouldn't, or it's probably more vice versa. The chickens will eat just about anything, and the bunnies, you know, they're a little bit more selective. But the thing about bunny compost is it's ready immediately. So you feed them this, and you can put them actually over your garden or over, you know, an area where it's going to be really easy for you to spread that compost around to feed it back to your garden, because it's not hot. Chicken manure is hot. You have to, it has a lot of fertility in it, so it has to break down a little bit. You have to let that compost more. Otherwise, it'll burn the roots and, you know, burn your vegetable plants, but not bunnies. Bunnies are good. So we have a lot of resources for you, and these should all be on your handout. You can call us. Actually, email is better, and then if we need to call you back, we could call you back. If you want to call, if you don't have an email, that's fine too, because we have a helpline. We're always happy to answer your questions. And one more. And so that's about it. That's my presentation, but I want to open it up to questions. Anybody have any questions about today's presentation? Yes.
Question or comment, that you validated a lot of stuff that I've been doing at home that I didn't realize were pretty much sort of like permaculture.
Yeah.
You know, growing under the trees. And a lot of the things I do, though, are because I live in the desert. And I have to find shade for many of my plants, or else they just burn up.
Exactly.
Know? And so, but I didn't know about the citrus and being able to grow. I just kept those always free of things underneath them. So
it's
interesting.
Yeah, a lot of people are scared to, you know, let compost accumulate under their trees because they go, oh, that breeds disease and it, you know, I'm gonna get more pests. But if you have an ecologically balanced system, if you really put things in place to promote that and to attract a balanced ecosystem under there, it's going to be okay. You may have to interact with that and manage that a little bit, but the worst thing that you can do is rake all of that away and leave just sand, you know, just bare ground, because then you have no fertility. The water's just evaporating. Yeah. And so permaculture, it really is very logical, just like you said. It's like things that we already do, but now that you can kind of see all the potential and how by design you can create something that's really sustainable on purpose, you know, and it's all connected, it will take you into the future. It will take us into our old age, and so we're, you know, where a lot of people give up gardening because they can't get down, or, you know, they lose interest. Who loses interest in a beautiful ecosystem that's productive, where all you have to do is go out and pick something to eat, or go out and, you know, do a little bit of work, like 30 minutes, and still be getting your yield? People could do that into their hundreds, right? So look at more permaculture. See how you can use it in your garden and in your everyday life. Okay, anything else? Yes, ma'am.
I have a question. So I've seen these big towers that are about 6 foot tall, they're similar to the tower that you had, but they didn't have as many, you know, they were appeared to be for larger type of plants, lettuce or whatever. Is that kind of like a, do they put waste in that also for permaculture? Are you familiar with what I'm talking
well,
about?
There are some, this is a garden tower, what I have, it's soil based. They also have tower gardens, which are hydroponics. So it's all, you know, the roots are inside the center.
I see.
And then they just flow water through it with nutrients. So somebody actually gave me one of those, and I never set it up because then I have to do something with the wastewater, because it is wastewater, because it's really concentrated with those salt-based fertilizers that you have to add. So the opposite of sustainable. Yeah, and I like this so much because if I overwater it, it's up down here in the water catchment, and then I just take it back and put it on top. It's really, really great. So and I only have to water the top.
Mm-hmm. So what's in that that tower?
Okay, I have one. This is lettuce. There's a bunch of lettuce. So I call this my acid tower. More acid-loving plants. So like five different kinds of lettuce. I have some arugula in there. Green onions, parsley, cilantro. And then over here, I have about five different kinds of kale. So more alkaline loving plants. So the difference in soil is, this is a lower pH, you know, under seven is neutral. And so under seven, like 6.5 here is what these like to grow at. These like to grow at about 7.5, a little more alkaline. So different plants like to grow at different pH levels because different nutrients are available, right? So that's why I separated the two. And I can tell you that I had to pick up spray off a lot of aphids from the cruciferous side, the alkaline side. They just went there. They've been together, but nothing's come into the acid tower yet.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, Maureen.
Are those made out of plastic or terracotta or what?
Food grade plastic.
Okay.
Yeah.
And where did you find something like that?
Online.
Mm-hmm. What do you look under? Like a
garden tower.
Garden tower. That's just
garden tower. It's a garden tower project. These guys, I think about 4 or 5 years ago, they started out with a 55-gallon drum, and they just cut these pockets, and they had a blowtorch. And they, you know, they molded it so that they did, you know, like 50 plants in this area. They put in a worm tower in the center, but then eventually they had it manufactured.
Because I've tried the strawberry pots, the terracotta strawberry pots, and they always dry out on the side.
Yeah. See, the thing is, you really just can't use terracotta here. It just evaporates. Yeah. It just sucks. So plastic is better in the desert, just for that reason. Or in ground with a lot of mulch, but or for strawberries, straw. Yes, ma'am. I water them just about every day because it's been really hot. But when it gets cooler, I'll have to cut that back. But I also have to make sure that the top stays moist enough because it all drains down. So oftentimes it'll be nice and moist down here, but not as moist up there, so I really have to just, you know, kind of feel it. I actually do feel it. I put my finger in there. But then maybe like I've been doing about a gallon a day on each tower, and I haven't had any runoff from the bottom yet because it's been so hot. Yeah. And sometimes I do a little in the morning and a little at night.
And that's out here.
Yeah, that's here.
Mm-hmm. That's the problem I have when I go to town or from one of the town for a week. Water source.
Yeah, you have to have a friend come over. Or, you know, last year we left for the summer and I pretty much had everything cleared out. There were a few things. There was an eggplant in there and a tomato. I thought, oh, it can take the heat. I'll put it in the shade. And I hooked up some water. I hooked up a drip system on a timer. Didn't really work because I was gone for a few months. So, but I think it would probably work for a few days or a week.
Any special kind of soil that you need there?
I started out with bagged potting soil. Added a ton of perlite. And they actually say that when you're setting it up in the instructions, and they have a video online. So you put in a lot of perlite because you don't want this to be too heavy. I've got mine on wheels because I rolled it around because, you know, I got to get it in the sun, out of the sun.
Right.
So it's all over the place. But, yeah, just the video says perlite soil. And then I've just been reusing this soil. And because I have my worms, I not only have the worms in here,